Good morning, everyone. Stephen Whiteside here with our look at the North American stock markets for Tuesday morning. We're coming up to 8:30 a.m. on the East Coast, and stock index futures and commodities are above fair value. Looks like we're going to make up Monday's losses at the open on Tuesday morning. Let's start off this morning taking a look at what worked and what didn't work on Monday. What didn't work? Transports. Transports were down hard. The Dow Jones Transport Index is now back on a sell signal after putting in a lower high. And the reason transports were down were the railroads, and there's the railroads putting in a lower high. Big sell-off yesterday, so we've got CN, CP, Kansas City, Norfolk Southern, and Union Pacific all down sharply on Monday. Now, we also saw a 2% pullback in biotechs on Monday. Not a lot of damage done here. We've got a couple of stocks that look iffy. Amgen looks like it topped, and Vertex traded through the lower channel line on Monday. Didn't close, closed just above the lower channel line. So a little weakness. A lot of people anticipating that the biotech bubble is going to burst, but certainly that is not the case based on Monday's trading action. What worked? Copper stocks were up nicely yesterday, so BHP, Freeport were up, Hudbay, Techcominco, they were all moving higher on Monday, and then of course gold and silver stocks. So we've got Barrick back on a buy signal, Agnico Eagle moving up, we've got Goldcorp back on a buy signal, Kinross back on a buy signal, and the silver stocks participated as well, with silver moving sharply higher, so Pan American Silver back on a buy signal. Speaking of commodities, we've got our commodity tracking ETF back on a buy signal as of Monday's close. Copper up sharply, and yes, I'm the one who said I wouldn't be trading copper right now because it was very sloppy, and that's what copper has done since I said that. So sometimes I might be a contrarian indicator. There's gold moving higher, platinum moving higher, silver continuing to move higher, and those were the ones that I was interested in. Looking at the crude oil traded into the channel on Monday. We need to close on Tuesday above 1716. We need to close above 3563 to give us a buy signal for gasoline and for natural gas. Natural gas pulled back yesterday. Again, we're looking for a move above the February high before we buy natural gas. Unless natural gas moves sharply downward, and then we'd reevaluate our breakout point. But right now, based on the fact that we're still trading in a channel with a low in early February, a high in mid-February, we're still trading in that channel. And so we're looking for a breakout of that channel to tell us which way natural gas is going next. Next up, looking at pieces of the puzzle here, we've got the US dollar on a sell signal as of Monday's close. And so we've got the currencies on buy signals, the euro finally on a buy signal. There's the Canadian dollar on a buy signal. The Japanese yen was on a buy signal as of from Friday and traded above the upper channel line for 3 days last week. There's the Swiss franc on its second day of a buy signal. So US dollar on a sell signal, other major currencies around the world on a buy signal. Looking at the VIX for the S&P 500, it moved higher yesterday, as did the VIX for the NASDAQ. There's the TSX, treading water up here, still on a buy signal. There's the S&P 500. Down, the cash index was down 368 yesterday. Last time I looked, it was up 4 points in the pre-market this morning. So it looks like we're going to erase those losses. Still looking for a breakout above the recent highs and looking for a move up to 21.25. That's our mathematical target to the upside. Looking at the NASDAQ composite itself, again, we're trading above 5,000, trying to get to 51.32.52. That was the March 10th, 2000 high. And so we're not that far away, but unfortunately, yesterday's market action certainly didn't head us in that direction. Last up this morning, quick look at a couple of 60-minute charts. We've got the VIX on a sell signal here. Of course, that's supported for higher stock prices. The VIX above 1333 on an hourly basis would give us a buy signal. Of course, we've got an open gap to deal with here. The VIX on a buy signal, of course, would correspond to the S&P 500 on an hourly sell signal. We closed on Monday on an hourly sell signal. So to get us back on track, to get us moving higher to that 2125 level, we need an hourly close above 2111.64. And we're certainly not trading that high in the pre-market this morning. Looking at the NASDAQ 100, we're looking for an hourly high above 4463.76. You can see there's the NASDAQ pulling down yesterday. It was led by the SOX index. And of course, we also had the selling in the biotech sector. Looking at the bank sector, we were still talking about the 328.13 level, and we're pulling away from that. So that's not going to be helpful to the overall stock market if bank stocks are not going to reach for higher highs. There's the XAU, still on a buy signal, 69.75, an hourly close below that would end this run in the XAU on Tuesday. And for the TSX, which ended Monday on an intraday buy signal, we're looking for an hourly close below 14,938 to generate an intraday sell signal on Tuesday. Okay, folks, that is all for this morning's presentation. Futures are still up in the pre-market this morning. So again, it looks like we're going to erase Monday's losses at the open on Tuesday morning.